There's no place to escape to.
This is the last street.
On the left.
From your glade.
That's when the cannibalism started.
What was that?
Go to sleep. Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to the last stream on the left. Hopefully everyone's doing well out there. Henry's making fun to his Modelo beer. And
Sweet
Marcus
medicine.
Parks. How you doing, Marcus?
I'm doing good. Wayne's World 2 is better than Wayne's World 1.
We
it's
were
very
talking
controversial.
About
this
very controversial.
This started hard.
I know, it's starting hard. I'm starting
you know what
hard.
You know what this conversation does? It's just show up this video. It's literally what you just did to get.
Wow. Okay. Wow. We're going to hop right into the video. It's Henry's mandate, and he's throwing one right
this
right
is literally
down the pipe.
What you just did to Kissel.
Okay.
Marcus.
Let's see it.
Let's see what happens here. What Marcus just did to me. Did he blow up my spot?
That's
oh my god!
I'm
that's what he just
exploded your shitter, bro.
You exploded my shitter?
I exploded your shitter.
What
bro.
You
fucking
exploded?
God.
What you exploded my shitter? I
you,
was simply
his shitter's
arguing.
All fucking all over the bathroom now.
Let yeah. me point counterpoint if we're gonna do point counterpoint. So Wayne's World 1, Henry or Marcus believes that Wayne's World 2 is better than Wayne's World 1.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot have a Wayne's World 2 without Wayne's World 1. Show some love for our elders. Show some respect for the OG.
I get it.
And that's why Wayne's World is. It has to be by definition better than Wayne's World 2 because without Wayne's World 2 doesn't exist at all.
There
that's
are just
impossible
moments,
to argue against.
It is true, but that's just facts. That's literally just factoids is a part of it. Wayne's World 2, though, for me, you know, I love Wayne's World 2 has the most moments I remember and repeated over and over ad nauseum to my friends later on. It's got the fucking, all Z needed a brandy bottle filled with brown M&M's. And that bit, and then all yeah. to be like, I ain't got no place to go. The Chris Farley moment of that is fucking
I'm
great.
The leprechaun. Come on.
I'm the
oh
leprechaun.
Oh my God, Mark. What the hell people did you just it's... transition into, Marcus? That was straight up an exorcist.
But everybody in the chat is saying, some people are saying this very interesting. People, you know, got Nikki says Shrek 2 is better than Shrek 1. I agree. I think Shrek would have been a lot better when Chris Farley. Who was the one who was originally had voiced Shrek. He was supposed to be Shrek. I think it would have been better that way.
Yeah.
Lord Charles says Wayne's World was just Bill and Ted. Who are you?
Wayne's what? World wasn't just Bill and Ted. There was
who
no time
you?
Travel. That's one of the worst analogies I have ever heard. It's like Bill and Ted in that there are two lead male actors. There is absolutely nothing. That would be like no. saying, that's like
Marquis
saying.
Des Moines says Gremlins 2 is better than Gremlins 1. Which
I also,
is also
agree with that.
That's fine. And I will
also agree with that.
I will also say Critters 2 is better than Critters 1 because you got the Critters ball that gave us more Critters. All of that checks out.
I also agree with that.
All of that checks out. But Wayne's World 2, let's be honest, it lost a little bit of heart because you had, like, for example, the fighting scene with Tia Carrera's
boss.
Okay.
It
got
fighting.
A little corny. But granted. Wayne's World 1, grounded in reality, I believe that
grounded in reality.
He could get Tia. Yes, Wayne could get Tia because he was a local celebrity, and he learned a language.
It showed that you had that movie showed everybody that you have to be funny to get a hot girlfriend. That's just
and you
it
have
goes.
To. And if they speak a foreign tongue, learn a simple sentence in said foreign tongue, and then you will know not cunnilingus. I'm talking about language, and then you can entice them because you tried.
Evil Dead 2 as well. Evil Dead 2 because Evil Dead 2 also. Was sort of a rehash. Of Evil Dead 1.
That one doesn't
with
count.
A bigger budget.
That doesn't count. That's the same movie.
I will say that my favorite line from both movies is in the very first one.
Camera
and,
one?
And
camera two.
No, it's camera it's Ed O'Neill. Why do they come to me to die?
No, it's the best. We'll just quote Wayne's World for the entire fucking stream. I don't care.
We have 57 more minutes, so yes. Sure, why not?
Yeah, guys, it's my fucking mandate. My fucking knees are showing.
Oh my!
Knees are showing.
Ooh,
got
I
the
like
sides and fucking socks and slides going, ready to fucking pump it out.
Did you
it's
get
my birthday
stoned?
This fucking
did you get stoned and do new T-shirt shopping? I don't think I've seen that T-shirt before.
Fresh T-shirt.
It's a good T-shirt. I
fucking
like it.
Got the fucking death. He's fucking cool. He's got sunglasses, or he could be blind. I don't know. But I save it for the stream because the people, they need new shirts. They need to know what my new shirt show is that whatever happened in 2020, We're moving on. And I'm brave because of this.
That's what the skeleton with sunglasses, because it may or may not be blind, holding a goblet. That's what that shirt represents to you, that we're moving on from pandemic. Healy. That's healing. Okay, great. I love it. We need to heal.
Also walked Wendy without a fucking mask today, and I felt I felt like I was nude. I felt like a new boy. Like I was just like, oh, fucking getting out there, bro. Fucking getting people sick with other shit this week.
Well, but as we know, actors, aren't they always wearing a mask?
I'm not the real me. You never met the real me.
I know I've never met the real you, and I guess that's for the best.
And I know we're kind of winding up this pandemic here in America. You know, everyone's getting vaccinated. But I did find some interesting pandemic factoids just today.
Before we start, this is huge news.
Please,
I'm gonna need everybody to fucking sit in. Before we could show any videos, honestly, people go to two places to get their news. They go to The Guardian and Joe Rogan. And this is the third place that people come for their news.
Yeah, oh, that's right.
Very sad if that's true.
Yeah.
All right. So let's start with it. COVID-19. Okay. Let's think about the sorts of numbers that can be added up to get to 19.
4,
17
5,
and 2.
10.
17 and 2.
Yes, those are numbers that can be added up to get to COVID-19. But you can also add 6, 7, and 5. Technically, those add up to 18. But what we're going to do is we're going to use our numerology using one name. So that adds 6 plus 7 plus 5. You know what has 6 letters, 7 letters, and 5 letters? Barack Hussein Obama.
Whoa! You fucking get it?
It makes all the sense in the world. I didn't even realize that doesn't add up to 19. It's 18.
Yeah. I thought about it. I double checked the math on what I saw, and when I did double check the math, I did see that those letters did add up to 18 and not 19.
The whole thing is just one number. It's only one number off from Barack Hussein Obama, and you know that a president who has not been president for 5 years has so much to do with what's going on right now.
It's the only rational explanation.
Television with Adam Conover and doing a podcast with Bruce Springsteen.
Bruce, yeah, the boss.
Bruce! Let's see what this video is. Let's show some videos.
Thank you so much for that insight, Mr. Parks.
It was huge.
You're welcome.
Enlightening the audience in ways we can't imagine.
Everyone's saying their minds are fucking blown. Everybody can't believe it.
And because of that, we are all dumber.
Here we go. Remember this. It's hard to be in COVID-19.
Oh my God, why is it her neck?
Sweet.
I am horrified.
We're loving it. To sound like he's pissing, but he's fishing.
It does, yeah. Oh no!
Serious.
Why would she cheat on you?
Damn yoga instructor.
Well, that'll happen, bro.
My son can't get over either.
That's horrible.
God, I'm cheating on the SATs. Never cheating on anything, have you?
Oh, he's making a joke. Opa!
Opa!
See one now? Oh.
Fuck yeah! You just shot him!
Holy shit, he got a gun! Oh. What the hell happened?
What did I do to deserve to be shot by you? Just because your wife is cheating on me and your son's an idiot doesn't mean you have to shoot me. You didn't do anything to stop it.
I didn't know the problem was happening.
Gotta fucking learn about problems ahead of time and help people solve them. That's what you would be if you were governor. That's what people would look to you for.
His wife didn't look like she was particularly sexually active. It looked like she was a little bit past that sort of moment in her life. So I don't know. Maybe she's not sexually cheating. Maybe she's emotionally cheating because he is too busy thinking about fish and thinking about renting out their spare rooms after their son is too dumb to go to college. So they need to make money because he's not going to make any money with the family. Maybe he should have been thinking about her because she's emotionally cheating with Herbert, because Herbert, he talks about knitting. He knows about bowling, and he'll be there and he'll go to the luncheon at the church.
I lost you, attorney. I've lost you. Because you know what I also think when it comes down to? You'd be surprised what an 85-year-old woman could do. because if she really wanted to cheat and she was really fucking horny,
that's
enough,
true.
Because you never know. Every
that's
once
a good
in
point.
A while, she could see a picture of you and you remind her of fucking Eisenhower, and she wants to get going and get ready to go, and she's just lying there anyway. If you lube it up, stick it in there, because I think they. When you're over 85, you can still get wet.
No, you're completely correct. I am sorry. I actually have to concede the point. I was 1-0, I think, but now I'm 1-1 with my Wayne's World 2 stance, which was impregnable because it was
Sage
so good.
Forrest says old ladies like sex.
That. You're 0-1 right now. You're 0-1-1. That was
all
a tie.
Right. Hey, I'll take the tie, but now that you mentioned it, my grandmother used to drug men literally with rum.
Oh, yeah.
She would get them drunk, and she was 89 when she passed, and she was doing a whole series of things in nursing homes. But they loved it.
Every once in a while, I imagine an old woman craves to suck a dick.
No, she really would. She would be like, she would point to all the tables and be like, when his wife dies, I'm going to get him. Like, she was horny for it her entire life.
That's real
yeah,
dark.
Yeah, but the wife was going to die. But nursing homes are very funny because they are dark. They know they're dying.
Yeah.
They know they're dying.
It's the last place. You're not going anywhere else from there.
The humor is pretty dark.
Do you think by the time you're 75, you'll be super into other 75-year-olds, or are you still going to be chasing like young people?
I think that you respect the look of elderly skin more because you see it on yourself every day, so it becomes very normalized.
Yeah.
Because if you looked, I don't think that I have aged, and I look at pictures of me from 10 years ago, and I have definitely aged.
Yeah, we're
but
old.
I see this every day, and so I just like I look at people that are of our age, and I'm like, that seems about the right. But then you forget, like people are still these teenagers still look like they're infants.
This is the chat. James Amaral says, my grandma always says, just because there's snow in the roof doesn't mean there's no fire in the furnace.
is all about hemorrhoids.
You know where we're gonna end up? This is honestly, I still think the three of us that our relationship future still might end up like this.
It's possible.
Like this video.
What is happening?
I'm just so
funny. That's honey, too. Is that honey or is that actually
like syrup?
No, that's syrup.
Little pancakes, depressing pancakes.
Oh, you knocked her over.
I mean, this is just, I guess this is funny. I think he's supposed to be having fun with it. It's like having lunch with my waifu. These guys are doing this.
So that's an anime character he's?
That is from
Evangelion. Oh, he's feeding her.
Yeah.
He's feeding her.
She's the naughty one.
Okay.
Well, wait a second. Did someone just say R.I.P. Willie Nelson? Is that real?
Did Willie Nelson die?
No.
If Willie Nelson died during this stream, I'm actually going to cry.
Yeah, if this is how we learn about it while I'm watching this man.
No, someone's just being an asshole.
Syrup. Okay, good.
Willie Nelson didn't die.
Seriously.
I think they just said because it was red hair.
Good.
Oh, my
good,
God.
Good, good, good. Willie, I know what's going to happen. I know it's happening one day. I know it is.
Yep. And there's is Willie Nelson's health? Texas Monthly said, don't worry. Willie Nelson is all right.
Everyone's saying it's okay. Everybody's like, Henry, what the fuck? Everyone's saying, I'm sorry.
I
didn't make the video.
We are nearing 40-year-old straight white men. Please don't do that to us. That is a big deal for us. I'm not ready for that. Please be sensitive of our fandom, please.
You might as well have told me fucking like Santa Claus was real and then he committed suicide. He's looked at the kids, like he looked at the pool and he's like, oh, no.
Oh, no. Question, and I have to ask this, and this is a true question. It was that last video involving the syrup and the pancakes and the lead character from Evangelion, or one of them, was that sexual? Do people jerk off to that? Because I have no idea what it exists.
Yes.
Why does it exist?
Yeah, no.
That is 100%
sexual. Yeah,
what is sexual about it?
That was insanely sexual, yeah.
What is it? Why would that be sexual?
Well, because when the cameras aren't rolling, he's coming on that thing.
Yeah, he said that is his girlfriend. But this guy, actually, he should watch this guy's videos because this guy can actually teach him how to. If he actually got his hands on a woman, he could figure out how to push them. Or not.
I would wonder. But Mark, do you have any idea why? What's arousing about it? The syrup?
I think it's just more of a precursor to the cum because the syrup has kind of like it has more viscosity than cum does, but it's still pouring a liquid on something that you're planning to come on later or something that you've come on earlier that day.
And it's making it truly like dirty.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And like they like to get things all mashed up and dirty and fouling and covering it with the syrup. And then all of a sudden, it's just all over you because you feel foul yourself. Mm-hmm. And so you want to smear it all over whatever is on this person because this, he doesn't have a future, whoever it is that made that video, you know?
No.
That's great.
No future. No future.
Well, let's check out this video and see what it's like to maybe feel some pleasure for a fucking second.
Please, Lord.
This guy's...
I've always been fascinated by the human body. I love to touch and be touched, to hold and be held.
Yep. Who doesn't?
Yep. It's a hot rock.
I think we all need to be nurtured.
Yeah,
I have a shoulder to rest on.
He's got a fucking huge cock, or that is fake. That might be a fake.
We need to lose some of our inhibitions.
He might just have a big ding-dong.
And build self-acceptance and confidence.
He needs jeans on. Look at all these scraggly bushes.
I'm just an ordinary man.
Oh, that's the best look.
Extraordinary gifts.
Oh, I can see he's got an extraordinary gift. No, that thing doesn't, it wiggles too much. It doesn't wiggle like a cock. It's real.
Oh, I think it wiggles like a cock. Why not?
Open up to your own pleasure.
Look at the nipples.
And passion.
Holy hell.
Silhouette.
Look at
this.
You know the combination.
That's a gem.
Life.
Are you
sorry?
And share it with others.
Wow.
So he kind of looks like Roy Cohen.
I encourage you to explore and enjoy.
Pleasure coach
Bob Patrick.
Do we know Bob Patrick? Pleasure coach. I'm going to have to look this guy up and see what he's been up to lately.
He's out there.
Well, BobPatrick.com does not exist anymore. It
not anymore.
A 403 forbidden.
Not anymore. No. He did have a bigger presence. I want to say he was shut down. I'm going to go ahead and say for legal reasons.
It's possible. Well, he still
because also I have... there might be a update from him later on in the stream, so you could see why I think he might not be the best.
Yeah. Well, he stopped his last view. Oh, no, wait. He's still doing, as of 11 months ago, he's still uploading stuff. But his most popular stuff is long in his past.
It's big ass nipples. So you think that just comes from tugging and tugging and tugging?
Like, he might tugging and tugging. Remember the guy? Remember that video we used to show at live shows all the time?
Are you thirsty?
Are you thirsty? Yeah, that guy.
Yeah.
How do you get those fucking big ass
nipples? Suction things. You do the suction things where the nipples come out. Like, you do the suction thing on the nipples where you can get these things at sex stores where you can put them on the nipples and it sucks them out and sucks them out and sucks them out so they get
but
long
then it
and
goes,
you can...
But then it goes back...
Bing, bing, bing.
Bing, bing, bada, bada.
Very good. How do I get
But then it goes back down, though. That goes back down. I think that is, he was born nipple first. That was the most difficult part of his body that his mother could squeeze out of
her.
You
know what?
I think those are natural nips.
Straight up, because the Yahoo Answers is gone, we don't have them anymore, I went straight to Quora. How do I make and keep my nipples bigger? So this is run with this. This is from Pia Struck. She runs a Danish site about inducing lactation for adult nursing relationship. Male or female, you can start this instant. Warm your hands and warm your breasts, particularly your nipples, with warm handed massage and gentle stretch. I don't need to make my nipples any bigger. Honestly, I don't even make. Don't ever break
tiny.
The little blood vessels or skin. Stay gentle. Don't overdo. Go and buy or create vacuum pumps that form
it
your
nipples.
It felt
too
longer.
Good. I feel like I shouldn't have done that on camera.
All right.
It made me
every
feel
day, this is saying straight up. Use the vacuum on your nipples every day for maybe 15 minutes.
A vacuum?
Be very gentle with the vacuum. It's
I hope
never
that they,
a quick fix.
I hope they clarified like the vacuum tube, not you don't just mow over yourself with the vacuum.
And this guy, Mike Vorkopek, shows, oh my good fucking Lord. I'm just going to, I don't know how to send this to you. I'm going to send this I think I can do this in a screenshot or some way, shape, or form. Because this guy's really been going to town on him using a lactation device. He's been pumping.
Is he getting milk out?
I am going to, Travis, can I send this to you to pop up? Is there any way to pop this up?
Yeah, just send it to me.
I'm going
to
send it to you
Thank
right
you,
now.
Travis.
You're going to really like
can,
this
because they
this
do say
really going for
the
it.
Male breast can create milk in times of need, unless that's a myth. I don't know if it is or
like
not.
Like what? Like a squid? Like you're trying to get away from danger? Like
that's what they say. The male breast can lactate if needed. I have heard. It might not be true. Maybe the chat could answer that
one. Yeah, he says, and Timothy Palin says, I use two different sizes of pump. Now I have plump nipples. And nice male tits with cleavage, and I can get a nice cock in between them. Everybody loves them.
Well, isn't that nice?
I did find on Amazon, I found a nipple cylinder. It's called the Size Matters Nipple Cylinder. Yeah. It's a beginner nipple cylinder. It's small. And the top review says, did as expected.
Hey,
well, that's fantastic.
That's all you can ask when it comes down to it. How many things are disappointing these days? I just sent it to you, Travis.
Yeah, that's Did as expected. And Harold E. Colley Jr., he absolutely put his name on this review. He said, "Madam has used these for a while on me. Half thick and half inch long allows sensual nipple play. Leaves them thick and often leaking after an hour play. Nice to orgasm from nipple play."
A lot of guys with their fucking names on their... Everyone loves nipple play. Get a set of chompers on there.
According to Yume Kane, personal breast growth from AA to D cup in 4 years. Yes, breast massages do really help in increasing breast size. Wow.
Oh, look at there. Look at that nice raspberry.
All right, here we go. Take a look at this guy. Now, this guy made it. He made it from one little nipple to one big. I don't know what he did with it. There's a lot of milk at the end of that.
According to LiveScience.com, unlike the female nipple, male nipples appear to be mostly decorative. However, if you have a hormone prolactin, which some men do have, then you can lactate. So it's prolactin is the hormone that makes the prolactin. Milk a barrel.
And if you really look at it,
you can get that
thread,
done.
I bought a pair of small nipple vacuums and a breast pump. The small pumps really pull them out extraordinarily temporarily, and I love the sensation of both of them and the breast pump. I'll be buying a second breast pump to get them both at once.
You know, I have no problem with him doing this. It is funny that he chose to do the review with the pictures and everything, though.
Oh, yeah. He's really enjoying this whole process.
Yeah.
He's into it. It looks like a mountain of Mars.
It really does look like I'd be up there with my pith helmet at the very tip. Oh, wow. Yeah, people's nipples are already hurting in the chat. That's really great.
Indeed. Well, we all have millions and millions of microorganisms living in our bodies, so there might be a little microorganism planting a little microorganism flag on top of that nipple right now.
I sure hope, but I mean, you know, who doesn't need a nipple enlarger?
Or maybe there's a little microorganism doing a free solo, and then he's like hanging on, and then someone's
cute.
Like filming him. Mm-hmm.
That's fun. That's Pixar.
Dude, that movie was scary.
And that's Pixar.
That's Pixar right there.
Konnichiwa, minasan. Kuma-chan desu. Kuma-chan desu. Yuki suki desu ka?
Name of this video is Yes, Weeaboo Still Exists.
Oh, look at that.
Yuki-chan. Yuki-chan daisuki desu.
It's cold, bro. Speaking of hard nipples.
Kuma-chan desu. Kuma-chan desu. Cha, mata ne.
How's Randy doing?
He's really very busy with his videos. He told me, I told him, you should get off the couch and you should start going to work. But he says he's got to put out content.
Hey, you know what? At least he is off of the couch and he is putting out content. That was an artistic expression of his love of, I suppose, anime and snow.
Of a kind, yeah, of Japanese culture. He's getting there, I guess. You definitely found a very specific corner of YouTube this week.
I really did. Yeah. I really got there. You know what I will say? You know what the only thing I think was reprehensible about that video is the male white dreadlock.
Well, he didn't have dreads, I don't think. I think that it was just long
hair. You go back
hair.
And look at it.
Because I didn't see the dreads.
He is just covered in filth.
Well, that is. Well,
he's a
true.
Filthy man. Yeah,
he is he's a filthy
covered,
man.
He's just covered.
I don't
in
know if we...
those are dreadlocks that are coming out of the side of his head, and they're not good ones. Not cool. Matrix twins ones.
I think that you know is mean? As someone who has longer hair now, but I did have it. That's just unbathed.
I think that's really greasy long
that's
hair.
That's just really greasy. I play video games, and I don't like. This is the kind of guy where if you go to his house, you don't touch the remote control. Because
you don't want to touch it.
You know it's like that's too personal of an item for you to touch.
He really needs a scrub.
Yes. Yeah. That is true. I think he may have accidentally given himself dreadlocks, but I don't believe that he had the intention of getting dreadlocks.
Oh no, he's not a Rastafarian.
No.
And I think like dreadlocks take time and effort and patience.
And I don't care who you get. If you get dreadlocks and you make them look very good, you take good care of them, it can be a very nice look.
Of course, absolutely. But still, if you were out there talking in a Japanese woman voice and hugging a small girl, I feel like maybe you could go for the buzz cut. I just think that of all of it, wouldn't you want to maybe present yourself in another way? I don't know.
I actually think that hair for that man diffused some of the tension that I got immediately once looking at him. I think the hair helped soften him.
Adam in the chat says white dreads just look like Grinch fingers.
That's true. I never thought of it that.
Puffin has his hair growing on his toes, so he looks like the Grinch right now.
Yeah, neglect clumps, Wendigo. That's correct. Neglect clumps. This guy's
Nicolette Klumps?
Oh, yeah.
Neglect Klumps. Because you got to, I mean, Ben, I'm sure you figured
out. Oh, I see Nicolette. I thought it was somebody that I had never, I didn't know Nicolette Klumps existed.
Yeah.
Now, if you don't comb your hair, because I had very long hair for many, many, many years. If you don't comb it, it's the rat tail. The rat starts right here, and then it spreads out if you don't comb your hair.
I just got to say, the best part about aging is, thank God I don't have to worry about that anymore.
Yeah.
You have too much testosterone, Henry.
That's a problem. I might have very much too much. And then also, I don't know what's going to happen to my body hair eventually. I don't know if it's going to fall out or just go completely white. And I'm just going to look like a true bear, like the men I've seen.
Ooh.
The men that made me get to these videos that I'm going to play.
The Abominable Snow Bear, you are going to make it on, what was the name of the website that you were on?
Chubarama.
Chubarama. All of Murder Fist for their sketch made it on Chubarama. A lot of guys enjoying that comedy.
Now time comes the question that we ask every time Henry does a mandated unusual of the stream.
Did that Modelo just hit you that hard?
This next segment, we're going to ask the question, will you shut off the stream? I hope that you don't.
I hope not. I hope you stick with us.
Thankfully, I got beer to coddle me.
Cozy up to a nice beer.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude.
What do we got?
About the Fist of Fishers.
Oh no. Oh my God.
Just so mortified.
Be ashamed.
Yeah, what mistakes have you made? You're fucking 15 years old. And everybody's like piercing statues, coffee in the morning, short skirts. We're so stupid. No machines and good works, we don't
care. We're driving minivans everywhere. I just feel so bad for the indoctrinated youth. There are some cool people in this, I'm sure, 2 years from now.
I mean, half of them are going to be, they're on OnlyFans now.
Yeah.
This was made a couple years ago.
Ugh.
Oh, look at that, the stare dance. That's funny.
Oh my God, she's almost dancing. You know, I'm happy. This is at least some version of artistic expression, so I'm almost proud of them. She had a turtle shirt.
Oh, she did.
Yeah, I don't know if that's allowed. We'll give them ice cream. Did they not have ice cream?
That's Fishers, because that's what they do. The
Fishers of men. Ugh.
Oh, Lucy's alopecia. I don't have any hair on my body. She's a hot alien. Nice.
So that woman just smacked that beverage out of someone's hand. That'll get
that's
you
cute.
Beat up.
Perfectly
oh my God,
sung.
So scary.
Gilliman's arm.
Also, that woman was wearing a monster.
Were responsible for the fucking massacre.
She was wearing a Monster Energy drink cap that has a lot of caffeine.
She got that for free. What is all this? All of this. Oh, good boys always catch our eye. No, you won't.
Oh, I see the monster drink with the Mormon. They took it from they took the Sign of the Beast logo.
Yeah.
Oh.
Who?
Well, I'm happy that they're getting together with friends.
People are saying that this is worse than the nipple cutting video.
It is. It is. This is so much harder to watch. Yeah. Even than the UFC fights I watched on Saturday.
Mark Peterborn, doesn't it sound like Scientology? We've always been. But if you're not, we're still your friends. That's bullshit. That's
absolutely bullshit.
Yeah, I don't think that would probably ostracize a bunch of people. Also, what is she doing with her hand?
Goes by the name of Moroni.
Wow. Oh, even the mom is into it.
That's how you know it's good.
Oh, yeah. CTR.
Why do they keep throwing things at each other?
I'm not sure. Wow, it's making me sad. Morm on. Stay calm and morm on.
Yeah, they had to fucking. They had to book studio time for that shit.
Well,
they
did. Well, you say shit. I say fantastic cover of a satanic song.
That is.
Look at that.
All right, this
and they love that guy. I have no idea who that guy is, but they loved him.
I looked it up. The Army of Helaman was an army of young men in the Book of Mormon known as the 2,000 Stripling Warriors.
Ooh.
They're extremely valiant and loyal.
Didn't the Mormons show up 2 weeks late to the American Native American War or the Indian American War? Didn't they show up 2 weeks late to that one in Utah? That was the whole story where they actually showed up and the war had ended.
With the that was the Skinwalker Ranch thing. That was where there was the war against the Utes and they showed up late. Yeah.
And then they were like, it's all good here. And then they just stayed there.
Yeah. And then they were responsible for a gigantic massacre in Mountain Meadows that they still refuse to acknowledge.
Now I wonder, they're 7 years since that video was made. I wonder whether or not half of them are either probably have like four kids already.
Definitely.
Right? Yeah. They already are. Most of them. Some of them are probably in our chat.
Probably.
You know, everybody else is just like, they just bailed on Mormonism as soon as they got a fucking taste of what freedom is.
Yeah.
Or they did what a lot of people do, which is go out into the air quotes real world, act like a crazy person for a year, and then go back and say, they're pretty nuts out there in the real world. It's like, no, you just acted insane for a year.
Don't the Mormons have a
Amish
version of Rumspringa? Don't they have like a thing?
Rumspringa!
Rumspringa!
That's the Amish.
But do they not have a version of that where they get to leave?
No, they have the Mormon. The Mormons go on mission, but they're 100% Mormon at all time. You don't even think about not being Mormon, but they do mission for 2 years.
No, they have no They have no Rumspringa. They're supposed to be Mormon always and Mormon forever, and there's no break from being
sometimes
Mormon.
Stupid.
Sometimes you get to go to France.
Yeah.
Well, what are you going to do in fucking France? If you're going to go, I guess maybe they'll talk to them, but I feel like, aren't they just rude to us perennially? If you show up with your Mormon gear, I mean, like, we don't really speak the language. Or maybe you took it in high school or some shit, then all of a sudden you got fired. Like, what?
I think that they might enjoy France because they can have bread and cheese, I believe. I think cheese is allowed in the Mormon church.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
R-rated. I feel like France, of all the places in the world, is like a naughty place to be. Am I wrong?
I would imagine there's plenty of, I mean, a lot of, remember, I mean, I know England was big with the Mormons. They loved England. Like, remember a lot of the early Mormons came from England because they sent all the people over there on the boats to do all of the, recruiting, which is why now most Mormons all look like almost the same person.
Wow.
Because it's just all
Brittle.
This.
Yeah. So interesting. Yeah. Well, yeah. I hope to erase that with this.
Well,
next
thank
video.
You. But, you know, very informative, Henry. Thank you so much for that
really
horrible, horrible video
it.
That really
yeah,
ruined
was,
this. Really God, ruined here this.
We go.
This is something
awful.
I think we can all learn again. Let's just say hello to Pleasure Coach Bob Patrick and learn a little bit what it's like. How to treat your man. Because that's
men,
what's really important.
Men
it's
are
been said
dogs.
That men are dogs. So, treat your man like a dog. Give him lots of care and attention. Rub him all
That's
over.
An actual dog.
Work on his sides, his neck and chest. Find the spots that he loves the most.
His belly.
No.
Build
He's got a new dog.
This is the guy. This guy is the reason I don't go to nude beaches, though.
Pet him and stroke him.
Of course he likes to be naked. He's buff.
And between his legs.
Hold on with the penis. Don't touch his...
Find that special place
and a little...
that makes him want more.
I don't like the way he's talking about it. It is a happy dog, though.
Very happy dog.
Oh. Ow. Whoa.
Very perverted owner.
We know that this guy... Do we know the guy doesn't jerk off the dog? Like, I can...
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
He's not...
No,
a,
that
he's
guy...
Not gonna,
no. No, no, no. That guy's not...
Oh, yeah. Oh, first... That guy jerks off dogs.
No, I don't know. So we have a point counterpoint. Dog. Henry, why do you think he jerks off dogs?
Because he just touched that dog's dick on camera while saying you need to rub a dog. Like
no.
You have to rub a man between his legs like you would rub a dog. That's what he said. He said...
I mean, honestly, great
do.
Point.
That's what he says. Who this guy fucks dogs. You're right, James Emerald.
Okay,
he fucks dogs.
Okay, I wasn't necessarily paying all that much attention to what he was actually saying because I was distracted by the dog.
This is the problem.
So I was distracted by how cute the dog was and how much fun the dog was having. And I did notice, he did get a little free with the dog's belly. When you rub
he
a big
really
dog's
did.
Belly, a boy dog, you got to make sure that you stop just below the penis. Because
or
you can
a
hit
girl
that thing
dog.
Real easily because you get excited because you're rubbing a dog's belly and the dog's going nuts and he's loving it, so you gotta be careful you don't go all the way down.
Never. But he... Why would you ever get close to a dog's cock?
Well, he was trying to rub his belly.
It's not like I'm going to accidentally suck the dog's dick. It's just a dog.
It's a good thing Georgie's a girl.
I'm just saying, like, wow. It's just weird.
Wow.
It's a dog. It's a dog. It's just a, it's like a, it's not a sexual thing. It's just a dog. It's a, another is, part of the dog.
I know. But still, the dog doesn't know. If you
the dog doesn't
touch...
have sex for pleasure. It's a dog.
Do you know dogs have sex for pleasure.
No,
yeah,
they don't.
They learn to like what? It if you teach it. With trees.
They would have to have sex.
Marcus.
What do you mean dogs don't have sex
for
pleasure?
No, dogs don't have sex. Only primates and dolphins have sex for pleasure. Dogs don't have sex for pleasure.
No more than a snake does. Sport. They have sex to win.
Or a cat. Cats don't fuck for fun.
Let me ask this, Marcus, because we have a thing in our house. You don't accidentally go crazy, right, if Carolina, like, touches your dingus.
Go crazy.
But I
go
mean,
crazy?
Like,
are you talking
like,
about crazy?
We joke about how, like, if
your
Natalie,
wife,
go,
your wife touches your
penis
and you go crazy.
If it is, my, like accidentally, like, touches my penis, I always go like, oh, no, you're waking it up. Oh, no, you're going to wake it up.
And that's, I mean, you, that's you going crazy.
Going crazy.
Well, yeah. But it goes into the problem is that sometimes if you just go just one tiny, I'm going to use my knee.
Mm-hmm.
It goes,
Are you okay? So in your, I'm assuming now a Mormon relationship that you're in, if your penis gets erect, then you just, then you by wife law, you're like, oh, now we have to go have sex again.
No, I want to. I'm saying I express that I want to. Mm-hmm. A lot of times she's busy.
So you don't think,
wait,
so,
Marcus, you
Marcus,
don't have
you
the
don't...
same reaction?
I mean, I'll, I mean, I might give it like a, hey there, like something like that, like an acknowledgement, but I wouldn't say that I go crazy.
He's not an 11-year-old who looks for how many penises have been touched so much.
It's an acknowledgement. I mean, yeah, I mean, strong. My wife has touched my penis many times. I would not say that it has become mundane, but
yeah,
it is a normal part of the day. I mean, it's just something that happens.
But if you were people, I'm getting vindication in the chat. Marcus, if you were laying in Carolina's back on her lap and getting rubbed like that man was rubbing that dog.
Oh, my God.
Yeah,
can you not do that right now?
And rubbing and rubbing and rubbing. You mean to tell me?
That's entirely different, Henry.
Look at what he would do that. This is what I'm trying to express.
You just said, no, that would require.
Than
that,
I do.
That would require you getting a full massage, which then, yes, of course. But if you just randomly have the palm of somebody's hand swap against your penis, I don't believe it's normal to immediately get aroused.
Yeah, I just find I guess actually, I must be a healthy man.
If she's rubbing my belly and she whacks my penis, then that's not gonna feel good.
But if she starts the way that guy was doing where he was digging in between the dog's legs and going, man, like, get it, yeah.
That guy was way too intimate with those dogs. But Marcus, so you stand by it. You don't believe that that man is a dog fucker.
I still don't think the man's a dog fucker. Okay. I think that, no, he's not a dog fucker. No, maybe he did compare men to dogs a little too much.
Okay,
he took the metaphor too far.
Here's a flip question. Do you think that he would look at his dog and think that dog is sad, and because the dog is sad, he would milk the dog?
Yes.
I could see him being like, yes, Tobert just needs it, and he does it, but he treats it very scientifically. Uh-huh. I could
Those
see
dogs
him doing that.
Have sucked on his nipples.
Those dogs may have licked his nipples, maybe. But I also don't think those are his dogs. I did not get the
distinct What does that have to do with? That's even worse.
That's even worse.
I did not get the distinct feeling that those were his dogs. I got a feeling those were his friend's dogs.
Well,
that's
his friends
would
gotta
like,
take the dogs
get
away.
Away from my fucking dog. First of all, put on some pants. I know that we invited you here, pleasure coach Bob.
He is the pleasure that coach. That is the here. Thing. You know what you're getting. Although I do think he needs to take off the white socks.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I would have to say as far as criticisms. And then all of the dog stuff, of course.
You know what he needs is a nice Italian loafer. And honestly, Kissel, you got those nice Italian loafers the other
those
day.
Those are nice.
You wearing them already? I've been
those
thinking
are
about
good.
Getting some loafers, switching from the slides over to some loafers. I think that's really fun.
Yeah, pretty cool. Pretty cool, guys.
This is actually, here's a picture.
Foot. Straight up.
Whoa, look at that thing.
Well, that's a white foot.
Oh, yeah. My
I'm
going to
start
goodness.
Calling you white foot.
Quentin,
it's my natural color.
Somewhere Quentin Tarantino just got aroused.
This is you want to see this is footage of me on my honeymoon. This footage right here.
Wow. I am so strangely impressed. Not at all impressed. Wow. What is it, a palm tree?
Is it
palm
some tree? Kind of puppet?
It looks like a dragon tail?
Maybe.
It's called Japan Attacks.
Is it his place, though?
I think that this is our.
Yeah.
Thank you, Crackula. You're right. Dogs can't suck.
No, that's why I said maybe they licked the nipples.
Whatever.
Who's going to pick all of this up? That's what I want to know. Oh, my goodness.
This is all a part of the art.
Well, it's going to be a part of the janitor's cleanup routine tonight if they don't. They need to clean those up themselves.
This isn't some kind of theater space.
This is somebody's.
But Henry, is all the world not a stage?
It is. It is. Just ask everyone who stormed the Capitol. The thing is, he is the son of two loving parents, most likely.
I mean, he's an artist.
And I'm not even disappointed. If I was his father, I wouldn't be disappointed. I would. I like the fake nuts. He has got big. I think it's a coconut tree, and his balls are the coconuts. Fake coconuts.
If I was his father, I would sit him down and ask him very nicely to explain his art to me, what it means to him.
Oh, I see. Now he's going in reverse and putting everything back together.
Yes,
this is now it all this comes is back just up. As good. This is just as good as the movie Tenet. The fact that Tenet won an Oscar
you can't
is
say
horseshit.
It, from now
it is
on,
disgusting.
If you want to say it, you have to use the hand motion.
Tenet is the worst movie to ever win an Oscar, and the Oscars are a scam, and the Lucas brothers were robbed.
The only thing the Oscars would have been good for is given the Lucas brothers won, and now that they didn't do it, the Oscars can disappear.
They all right, go. Well, there he is, and he put the whole room back together with the same prosthetic he took it apart with. Well,
with the power of technology.
Although, it is funny that now that I think about it, we did have two Oscar nominees on Roundtable of Gentlemen.
Yes, we have. Yes, we have. Very
no
funny.
Winners yet. No winners yet.
No winners.
I think that's what's holding them back.
Could be.
That they were a part of that. You know, I remember when my mom first found Murderfest videos, and it was before we didn't know what the hell we were. I mean, obviously, we never really knew what we were doing. But there was a video that my mom found.
No, Murderfest was very funny.
It was funny, but me getting fucking crazy fucked in the ass by Holden as the boogeyman. When I was dressed up as a lady, I was the tooth fairy, and I was all covered in Vaseline. And I remember it was also the first time I'd ever taken an Adderall when we were shooting it. So I was all
oh,
like,
that's a good idea. Yeah, that's a good idea.
I was all slathered with Vaseline and getting like humped real hard. And my mom watched it and she cried for 2 days.
Yeah,
she didn't know what it was. She didn't understand that it was art. And then all of this was the stage. But then her whole thing is like, aren't you trying to get a job? How will this reflect in you getting a job? And I was like, this is sketch comedy.
Yeah.
Like, no,
this is bigger than a job.
This is bigger than life, Mom.
Mm-hmm.
Was
that before or after the video where Holden was the ass face that sprayed shit
all over Carly?
All over Carly, yeah.
Oh, that was before. That's later. That's technically like when we got good. Was that video?
Yeah,
with the ass
kissing
face.
Booth. Fantastic. I got a blowjob from a hand puppet cockroach that Holden mm-hmm. held.
That's out there.
Marcus got to be Toothless Joe.
Toothless Joe.
I got covered in shaving cream and fake blood, and Jeffrey Joseph, dressed as a mailman, dragged me out of Holden's apartment.
So
yeah,
you destroyed your apartment. Yeah, you destroyed your apartment.
I lived there too at that time.
Ben's apartment. Yeah. Absolutely fucking wrecked that place. Yeah. It was fun.
But that was such a funny bit there.
It was worth it at the time. Again, that was with Huffing It. That was the first time we were ever paid to do a web series.
Yeah,
that was money. We didn't pay. We paid Marcus.
Wait, y'all got paid for that? I didn't. You kept that for me.
Production.
I didn't get
budget.
Anything for my blow job. I got blown by a cockroach. I didn't get anything.
You got blown, and we gave you dollar bills.
By a fake hand puppet held by Holden.
I had to walk underneath the BQE wearing. Nothing but overalls, no shoes, bare feet walking underneath
the
BQE.
Spasming.
Yeah.
For Murderfest. Spasming.
Now, oh, here. Barry Evans, Mamie Henry will be the Oscar winner.
Maybe. Henry, I'm telling you.
Or give me a role. Give me a role to play before this, because next video, give me a role to play. I'm going to win the Oscar right
Well,
now.
We already know that you could have been nominated for your fantastic performance for Spinny, of course. So yeah. Let's do something. What's big right now in the Oscars? The Oscars right now, they love a rags to riches story. So mm-hmm. Henry Zebrowski, you are the victim. You are a... Okay, it starts off really disgusting, though, just so everyone knows. You
they
are
love a rags
the
to riches story, but they also love a rags to rags story where nothing ever gets better.
You're the victim of incestual rape, and you have to be given up for adoption as a baby.
Yeah.
This is the beginning. Okay, and so the entire story is you finding out that your father and mother are also, wait, your sister? I don't know how it will work.
For no cheer, here's a shout out because you're a defense contractor who can't get stoned anymore. What's going on?
Your father is your father, but your mother is your sister. We're talking a Chinatown situation here.
Sister. And so the entire thing is you trying to fight the legal system so you can marry your sister, because when you guys met, you didn't know that was your mother. And you also didn't know that was your sister, but you fell in love in real life. And so this is a story about vindication, about love, and about the legal system trying to stop you and your sister slash your mother from having sex and having a nice marriage together.
So I'm like a lawyer. I'm defending, like, I'm on the stand.
Sure, we can put you on the stand. Sure. Okay. You found out the woman that you love was your sister, but then you also found out, wow, that's also my mother. And you want the love to continue, but the state has said, because it's so disgusting, that it's not allowed. And so basically they are trying to legislate love.
Not just the state. Henry, you are sitting in front of the Supreme Court, my friend.
Okay.
So here he, defendant Polish shithead, you're here, and we hear you want to have sex with your sister, who is also
it's
your mother.
It's shit-hiot. First of all, it's pronounced shit-hiot. And first of all, I want to say thank you, Justice Rudy Bader Ginsburg III, for being here. And I want to say thank you for taking my testimony. All of you say you've been close to someone.
Yes.
But have you ever... not just shared a uterus with someone, but also shared a wedding bed. If you all can understand what that trip was like, because not even knowing how close someone can be to someone later on, post a uterus, post that time, when you thought that, excuse me, first of all.
You're drinking in the in front of the Supreme Court.
I brought my own.
You brought your, okay.
I didn't purchase it.
Okay.
But the idea that I didn't know I could find that closeness again, because we were so close when we were in the uterus together.
Well, you were in the uterus of your mother. You weren't really together, but
and
my
sister.
It was like she was. It was a previous apartment. Why can't I love?
Okay.
Why won't the government let me love?
Well, wow, absolutely. Polish sheet heat.
I want to be with her sister, mother, brother, wife, husband, cousin, sister, mother.
Henry, you're out of the shot. You need to get back into the shot.
I'm fucking Christian Bale. They follow him.
They follow him. That is very true. They do follow him back and to the left. That's not him. Unfortunately, you didn't make the case whatsoever. So you don't get to marry your sister, who was also your mother.
Unfortunately.
And that's why I brought this gun.
No!
Fucking yeah, hell yeah. Me versus the Supreme Court.
Is that what it's called? Me versus the Supreme Court for your consideration?
Yeah.
That being said, Henry, yeah, in the kayfabe world, you didn't get to marry your sister slash mom. But in reality, you did win yourself an Oscar nomination.
That's all I got. All I need is to be nominated. That's the only bump I need. That'll help me get the sketch show on Show Max 9.
You're going to want to check out CISO.
CISO, is that the CISO. One?
CISO.
CISO. It's fucking another one gone. Let's see what this. Let's see what this next video is. I don't even know what the hell this is. Oh yeah, it's called Dog Meat.
Oh,
this is for you, Marcus.
Thank you.
She's kind of got a Audrey Hepburn vibe.
I guess I could have been dog meat.
You coulda. Anyone can be dog meat if they really want.
No, they can't just be dog meat. The only one is you, Marcus.
Hey, I'm merely the latest in a long line.
Can we rewatch that?
If you want to.
Yeah, I actually. What is the machine that is behind her? Literally, is anyone in the chat that could
this
identify
is all, she's
what?
Cute, though.
She is very beautiful.
Yeah, yeah, she's
but
cute.
What is the machine?
I guess I could have been dog meat.
It's a drill of some kind.
It's a triple drill. I like the shoulder shrug.
I guess she could have been dog meat.
She could have been.
She's cute. That's cool. That's all she needs. It's just this is what they made.
There are many dog meats. Dog meat.
Her jacket is backwards.
Yeah, backwards jacket. If anyone could describe what can, I don't know why I'm fascinated with the triple drill, but I never saw anything like that. Who knows?
Okay. Yeah. If there is any drillers on our chat that know anything about drills and can tell us what those drills are, that'd be fun.
You know who I want to meet? Some guy who works on the line.
On the line.
Kind of, like a Wichita lineman, like someone who does construction on like the
big
power wires.
That's supposed to be the most dangerous job in the world, people who work up on the line.
It is.
Or Mark Wahlberg works in that one movie where he looked like a man that somehow had the ability to work out 10 hours a day, but also work the line.
Oh, he works the line. Okay. Or you could also work the railroad. I think that would be called working the line.
That's working the line.
No. I want somebody up on the power lines. That's fun as hell.
Somebody in the assembly line, like an assembly line worker, we could fly over to
That's
another
boring.
Country.
That's fucking boring.
You know what? I wonder because you do weigh a little bit. So Henry is deceptively small. Because on screen, he looks bigger because that's how actors work.
Yeah.
I feel like you could fall.
I'm bigger than a camera.
You are bigger than a camera. I feel like you could fall from a higher height than me. I think that you would live and spring more. I feel like I would, if I fell from a power line, I'm dead. I think for some reason, your little Polish, like this strange ability. Yeah. I think it would actually make you survive.
The key is tucking in. Whenever you fall, that's the real key. You got to lift up. You got to tuck in like this, because what that does is protect your spine. You got to protect your neck, because that's where it gets weak up here. Where if you could take the fall back here, you really want to fall
like a turtle.
On your ass. My problem is I don't have enough an ass to save me in any way, shape, or form.
I just feel like you would survive for some reason.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Yeah,
I feel only just because you were, but also I feel like it depends on your level of inebriation when you fall, because I do think that also sometimes saves people.
Drunker you are, more likely you are.
Because you're just like,
You're just relaxed. You're just relaxed.
Okay. Oh yeah, Bumbles bounce. That's a fun plan. Chance at tuck and roll, Rhiannon. You know, this next one, this is all about. It's hard to be a worker man. I mean, that's what this whole video is about. This is what our whole fucking stream is about.
It has been a very dusty roads. Yeah.
It's all about being, if you know a man, rub on his belly, rub him aggressively on his belly all the way down to his dick and balls, because that's the only way to pleasure a man. Rub his sides, rub his front, do whatever you got to do, because, I got nipples, can you milk me?
Be a little more sensual once you get down low.
Yeah. You don't got to fucking scratch at it. You got to scratch at it. But honestly, now it does sound like nice. The idea of like two kind of like semi-vigorous rubs on either side of the dick and balls actually sound kind of fun. This is all about the working man.
Okay.
Yes, Lively.
Lively has changed.
Oh, you're supposed to put an ounce in Wonderland. You're supposed to spread your body out to lessen the point of impact.
Oh, when you fall. So opposite of like the World Trade Center.
What could happen?
Oh no!
That did not do it right.
No, it's not level, bro.
It's a bad idea.
It's not level, bro. You're on the pallets, bro. It's not good.
Oh, oh no!
What is this man doing?
Oh, that's my worst fucking nightmare!
Degloved!
What the hell? Was that real?
Fucking eyeball! It's hard to be working, man.
It is hard. These guys are doing it all wrong. Dude, yeah, why would you hit that there?
30-degree burns! That's gotta be hurt. My steam was really fucking
hurt. Like a White Castle burger.
And I'd be done with the job. I knew better than to wear my gloves when I was operating a lathe. I knew better than to calibrate all the lathes.
It seems like he's pretty safe here.
Oh no!
He lost his arm!
And it's what I'll be paying for the rest of my life.
Yeah, you gotta be careful around the lathe.
You really do, man. because it goes.
Oh, look at all that blood.
That's not.
These people just need to have a just one maybe day of retraining.
I don't know, but they seem to be all out of sorts because that guy just fell fucking right on top. Like, I could see this happening.
Yeah, I don't think we'd do very well in the factory living. Oh, fucking shit!
Hell yeah!
That was like out of Freddy versus Jason. No, and now it starts a fire.
Wow, look at all the flame.
Begin your work day every day with an attitude that I'm going to do the best possible job I can, that I'm going to do it in the safest manner I can.
First thing you have to do is look to see what might happen to you.
If you go on the job and halfway asleep, you go get hurt.
Yes, you are.
We should all stop and think before we do any job.
That's a hard-working woman.
Look at this guy. What a moron.
I remember when I was trying to get free cable, I was grabbed the wrong part of my back of my cable box. Fucking set me across the room. Sucked.
Hey, how are you trying to get free cable like that?
You go and I forget what it was like. Man, that's cute as hell.
Carry on.
Look at him, fucking. That's the worker man rage right there. That's the problem, man. He's getting mad.
Uh-oh.
And then he fucking loses.
Oh, he jams his ass.
Oh,
I'm going to need that back.
I wouldn't have lost these.
Oh, you're just holding your fucking. Fucking dope.
Oh, trying to take that. Oh, no.
That does suck.
Oh, you're
dead, man. That means you're fucking dead, dude.
If anybody watched UFC on Saturday, you saw a dude shatter his leg like that.
That's got to be scary, too. That's
horrible.
That's instant death.
Safety and procedures must go hand in hand.
Well, a lot of them, I think, you get...
Oh, my God.
They're all drifter killers. Oh, my God.
Yes.
I just...
That man's eyes are horrifying.
I think we should work as a team. Be safe.
It's Wayne Williams.
Because our eyes are in one another's hands.
Oh, yeah.
You
gotta be careful
with this. You got it. Oh, don't get the cutting torch near the
it's
fucking.
Not good.
Is it oil tankers?
I don't think he.
No,
fucking shit! I
just
got it.
The amount of damage. Did I do that? This is gonna be tough to talk to your manager on Monday to be like, sorry, small explosion.
Yeah, he didn't look at the sticker on the side.
He got it.
Will you? Honestly, that is a very intense question.
That's a very intense question.
I don't know the answer to it.
What do you think is the most dangerous thing that can happen to us as podcasters or as comedians?
Well, you could probably sit down. Let's say you think that you break the chair, the thing that the chair sits on that spins, that little thing pole goes straight up through your anal cavity all the way through your throat, and you slink down into the chair and you die, ironically enough, doing what you love, which is sitting in a chair next to a microphone.
It's very Final Destination.
Yeah, it's possible.
I would say tripping on a cord, falling right into this part right here, like where I see where it gets a little sharp right on here.
Yeah, sure.
Falling into that, hitting your throat,
that
break
could
your trachea, you fall on the ground. Carolina's going somewhere. She's got some sort of fucking errand to run.
She has a new friend.
She's not even thinking about you.
She's hanging out with this Brad guy who is bisexual, and she swears that it's
they're
like...
They're just friends. They go
they're
shopping.
Just friends.
She's so happy to finally have somebody she can shop with.
Yeah, but...
Mm-hmm. I'm going to say heart attack.
I'm going to have a fucking heart attack. Beer. Yeah, that's a big one. Or plane crash. Going from show to show. We all die in a plane crash together.
Thank you for saying the scariest thing. I'm glad that you said the scariest one.
The scariest and most likely one yet. Mm-hmm.
It's not the most likely.
Crash.
It's very rare to die in a plane crash. Why are you doing
car
this?
Crash. Think about it that way, because we're going to be driving from show to town to town to town later on this year.
Marcus,
so we're going to be in a car a lot.
You are technically not being artistic right now because you're just saying truthful sentences. We're supposed
scary.
To be making it up. You're supposed to say like a waffle iron. Like, and then you literally just said two very practical ways that humans die that is extremely plausible.
Very
so
scary.
You really, I'm just going to say you dropped the ball on that.
I'm very, very scared.
I'm scared.
You know what? At least we, this is my last video. At least we'll end on this and we'll come back and say goodbye. But at least we don't have this guy's job. Look at this fucking shit. This is insane.
Whew.
Look at this shit.
I do wish that you could tame a tiger, but you just can't.
Look what he has to do. Watch this. He's going in there.
He's got to clean his teeth.
Something wrong with the tiger's tooth.
Yeah, but that tiger trusts him, though.
I guess so. But
tiger's
still,
in toothpaste.
I wouldn't want to do this fucking shit. Look at this fucking guy. What is this guy's problem?
Did he get it? Did
he
snag it?
Oh. Oh, my God. Then it just starts playing with him like it's Wendy, dude. And it's just not. It's that is so. It would take me so long to get over that.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm sure it had a bad toothache.
Yeah,
so
it probably feels better.
If you keep
playing, no.
If you keep, don't feed him the tooth. You don't need to feed it the tooth again. If you keep a tiger fed, it won't eat you, right? Like, what happened with, I don't know what happened with the two very famous performers that used tigers in Las Vegas.
Siegfried and Roy?
I don't know what happened. I watched the breakdown. We actually watched the breakdown of that on this stream. And still no one knows why the tiger slipped out.
I believe the tiger was too old. I don't remember. That's the thing, is that, like, they can grow out of their training.
Sure. You just get grumpy like everybody else. Yeah, you just get grumpy. Yeah. And the tiger is like, I remember when America's Funniest Home Videos.
Where's
was
my cut?
Where's my cut? Yeah.
I see how you guys live. Where's my fucking cut?
Good point. Like chimpanzees, where they always have to send the chimpanzees that they use in movies and TV. They always got to send them to the fucking chimpanzee refugee camps because they get way too dangerous. So fucking
attack. You always got to jerk them off before they do the shots so they can
always
pay attention. And same thing with actors. What a great stream.
What a stream. What a stream.
What
a stream.
A stream was done.
Thank you all so much for being with us this fantastic Tuesday night.
Woo!
Thank you to everyone who gives to our Patreon. We, again, obviously, you are the reason we exist. So thanks so much.
Thank you.
And this will be up on the YouTube fairly soon and until
the
they get upset and then take it down
you
or something.
That's for fucking you, you piece of shit. But I won't see you this weekend because I'm going to Hawaii.
Yeah.
Yes, indeed. Hawaii is calling Henry's name. Although Henry said that Hawaii doesn't have the greatest food, which I was very stunned to hear because I would think that it would have some of the best seafood in the world, but I don't know.
Pork. Eat the pork.
Oh, I'll be
eating
pork.
I mean,
pork so much my fucking nipples are going to get fucking longer and I'm going to get those suction cups.
Yeah, my brother went a free trip to Hawaii when I was in college. He took me and we got to see Sheryl Crow.
That's amazing. Did he call
romantic?
Did he call into a radio station?
He worked for Wells Fargo. He won like a sales competition. And so he got like a free. And so we got to see Sheryl Crow perform a corporate gig for a bunch of Wells Fargo employees.
You got to hit him up and take him to Hawaii one day. That's what you got to do is put the bill.
I got to.